In this video, we are going to calculate the history profit for positions that have been already closed. It will output the text my last profit was, followed by the last profit from the first order in the history. As soon as one of the positions here is closed, we will see that we get a value. Let's speed that process up a little bit, and here we are. And now you can see the profit, the ticket number and the position and the direction of the trade. And now we want to find out how we can create an expert advisor that is going to calculate the order profit for history trades. To do that, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. And now you should see the Metaeditor, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleOrderHistoryProfit. Click on Continue, Continue and Finish. And now you can delete everything above the OnTick function and the two command lines here. First, we need to include the file trade.mqh. It contains several trading functions. So now we can create an instance of the class ctrade. That will be called trade, and we are going to use it to open positions later on. Inside of the onTick function, we are going to calculate the ask price and the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double for the symbol on the chart. And we use symbol underscore ask or symbol underscore bid to get the ask or the bid price. Normalize double and underscore digits will help us to calculate the right amount of digits behind the dot. This currency pair has 3 digits and this one has 5 digits. And if we don't have any open positions, so positions total would be less than 1, we will use trade.buy to buy 10 micro lot and trade.sell to sell 10 micro lot to open 2 testing positions. So please don't do that on your real account, but we need some positions to calculate the last profit. That will be done by calling the function getLastProfit, but we have to code that. In the onTick function, we will use command to output the text my last profit was, and in a new line, the calculated profit that we are getting from the getLastProfit function. So let's code that function now. It will return a string. The name is getLastProfit. We don't have any parameters here. First, we need to create a few variables. MQL5 is a little bit complicated. There are deals, orders, positions, and ticket numbers. What does it all mean? Well, if you want something, that would be an order. The broker can decide if your order is executed or not. If it is, it becomes a deal. And in that case, you will have an open position that will go in one direction or another. So let's figure that out. First, we need to get the history by using history select. We want all the data up to the current time. Now we go through all the deals. Here we use an unsigned integer as counter. And as long as it is less than the total number of deals, we will increase it. Now we need to look for a ticket number. That ticket number is the return value for the function history deal get ticket. But we need to use an if statement, because as long as we have no closed position, we don't have anything inside of the history. The order profit is calculated by using history deal get double for the ticket number, and we use deal underscore profit. We also need to get the order type by using history deal get integer for the ticket number, and this time we use deal underscore type. Now we need to get the currency pair. This time we are using history deal get string for the ticket number. And to get the symbol, we use deal underscore symbol. Let's get the deal entry type to check for close types. Once again, history deal get integer for the current ticket number in combination with deal underscore entry will deliver the deal entry type. Now we want to know if the currency pair fits. So if the currency pair for the order in the history is equal to the current currency pair on the chart, and if we have a buy or a sell order, so if the order type returns order type buy or order type sell, and if the order was closed, so if deal entry equals 1, that is when we want to do something. We set the order type to sell. If the close type was buy, that sounds a little strange, but when you look into the history, you will see that we have buy and sell orders. Whenever you open a buy order and take the profit, that would be a sell. So if you open a buy order and close it, that would be a sell trade. And in the other case, if you opened a sell trade and close it, that becomes a buy trade. And in the end, we calculate the result. That's a string. It contains some text. And the calculated values for the order profit, the ticket number, and the position direction. So let's close the brackets. Finally, we want to return the result to the main function. That's the onTick function here. Now you can click on the compile button or press F7. That should work without any errors here. And in that case, you can click on the little button here or press F4. To go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the file SimpleOrderHistoryProfit.exe5, enable the visualization here, and start a test. And here is our little expert advisor at work. So far, we have no closed position, but as soon as that changes, we get the last profit. And in this little video, you have learned how to calculate the profit for the last position that has been closed in the history. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.